Greetings everyone, this is Alt Lexington playing Ursula again for the Meraki Revenge Klingon Fleet. Since my last video, I had a few more skill points to earn so that I could reach level 50, so I did a quick Kaelus Expanse which did the trick. I fought Federation ships helping in the Klingon War. Once I reached level 50, Chancellor Jumpuck hailed me because he wants to formally recognize my contribution to the Empire, which I know from looking at the commendation, the Klingon reward tree, the different levels that I've achieved. I know I'm going to get the next rank of ships from this promotion. So, if you watched my previous video, short-lived as it was, my little torpedo boat is going, and it's going to be replaced by something new. She was a good ship. She proved herself much better than I expected. But I'm moving on to bigger and better things. So let's follow this mission, promotion, go to the first city, and see what Chancellor John Park has to say to me. Maybe I should put on some full impulse to get into orbit quicker. There we go, beam to first city. And talk to Chancellor Jumpuck. Leader of the Klingon Empire. He rose to power after General Martug, well, Chancellor Martug then, was assassinated or killed in battle or whatever. Go before the Klingon High Council. I've been summoned to have my contributions recognized. So it's yet another new ship for Ursula. Here we are, entering the Great Hall of the Klingon Empire, the government, with their open door policy. And the Chancellor right there where you could get him with a sniper shot. Talk to Chancellor Jumpuck. Promotion, Lieutenant General. General Ursula. You have fought for the Klingon Empire with bravery and honour. Your successes on the field of battle will live in song for a thousand years. Kabla! Gold members have earned a retraining token, which I am a gold member. Recognition of their service of the Empire. Visit a retraining officer on Kronos or Grenalda Station if you wish to reallocate skill points, which I probably will. Continue.
Sir.
Now, we don't want that episode. I wish these episodes wouldn't automatically pop up like this. It gets annoying. So, now I'm allowed to buy a new ship. Or use one I've already got that I wasn't able to use until I reached level 50. And I know exactly what ship I'm going to use. Let's go to the shipyard and find out. Let's get past Q and his Omega event. to transporter chief, beam to shipyard. I've got a frog in my throat. Excuse me. Here we are at the shipyard. Ready to claim our reward. Normally you get a mission to select a new ship, but I didn't this time for some reason. Let's just have a look on the available tab. Nope, it says nothing about new ship. Which is odd, because it gives me permission to buy the new ship without actually giving me a mission to go and buy it. Normally, when you get a new ship, the Klingons require you to test it in combat. Anyway, let's go to the sea store this time instead of going to the talking to the ship guy. Let's have a look and see what he's got actually. So my new rank is Lieutenant General. I've already got that ship, because it had the plasmonic leech on it, and I bought it, and it was and it became available for all my characters, and so I got the plasmonic leech for the price of one ship. If I was a Federation character, I'd have to buy it on every Federation character I have to get the plasmonic leech, but on the Klingon Empire side, you only have to buy one ship, and you'll get it for all characters. Ooh, I could get the boar tusk, because I've already purchased the tactical version of it, but I did that a long time ago. Ah, maybe it's that ship's, the one with the plasmonic leech. One of them does anyway. Ah, those are fleet ships. We don't want fleet ships. It's funny, once you become Lieutenant General, all the ships open up. But no. I've already purchased something from the sea store that I wish to use. Ships, tier 6. Let's have a look. Flagship tier 6 cross fleet flagship bundle faction tier 6 cross faction flagship bundle. That's what I bought. That's 9 ships, all the latest ones. I've already tested out the Scimitar on a Romulan character, and the Federation one on my Federation character. Now it's time to test out the Klingon one on a level 50 character, if I can find it and claim it. Ooh, available pilot ship. There's that Scimitar I used, I believe. Klingon. Getting a little confused, but where is this ship? It's got to be here somewhere. Maybe I have to claim the entire bundle before I can get the ship itself. Does that do anything in my inventory? No. Ooh, that promotion got me some more slots as well for my inventory. Probably find in a minute when I go to the bank that I've got bank slots as well. And it gave me a lot of dilithium. Oh no, that dilithium came from me playing Kaelus Expanse just to finish up my skill points enough to get level 50. I only needed about 3,000 of them. So, what ship am I looking for? I'm looking for the engineering one that goes with the Klingon fleet, and it's, what's it called? This pack allows you to claim T6 Odyssey bundle, T6 Bortescue bundle, T6 Scimitar bundle. Don't want that, that's Federation. That's Federation, that's Federation. These are the free Klingons, and these are the free Romulans. And I want the Klingon, not the science, not the tactical, I want the Kaelus War Battlecruiser. That's the one I'm looking for. And there it is. This starship features a Lieutenant Commander Universal Command Specialist Bridge Officer Saint Blah. The Kaelus War Battlecruiser comes equipped with the Adaptive Emergency Systems Universal Console. When activated, it provides a substantial boost to damage and damage resistance for a short time. This console effects are increased by 50% if the starship's current hull hit points are below 50%. This console also provides a passive bonus to max hit points and energy damage resistance. This console mod can be on an Odyssey, Scimitar, or Bortescue variant. You may only equip a single one of these consoles. After achieving level 5 in your Kaelus War Battle Cruiser's Starship Mastery, you will unlock the Adaptive Hull Plating Starship trait. While this trait is slotted, activating any hull healing or command bridge officer ability will boost your maximum hull hit points for a short time. This effect stacks up to 3 times. Rank acquired, Lieutenant General, that's me. Hull strength 50,000 at level 50 and 59,000 at level 60. Shield modifier 1.10. I'm not sure I understand that one. Crew 3,600. 4 weapons, 4 aft weapons, 4 device slots, 4 bridge officer stations, lieutenant commander, commander engineering, lieutenant science, lieutenant universal, lieutenant commander universal command. Console modifications, 4 tactical, 5 engineering, 2 science. Well, it makes sense, it has more engineering slots because it's an engineering ship. Base turn rate 6.5 degrees per second. That is not brilliant, but then it's a cruiser. So you don't expect to have a brilliant maneuverability on a big bulky ship. Impulse modifier 0.15, inertia 30, plus 10 engine power and plus 10 weapon power. Can load dual cannons, although on cruisers you're better off going with beam arrays because they have a large firing arc or omni beam arrays. Console Universal Adaptive Emergency Systems. The console doesn't come into its own until you complete the ship's mastery, I suppose. Starship Ability Package, Absorptive Plating plus kinetic and physical damage resistance. Enhanced weapon banks plus critical severity. That's good. Enhanced plating plus energy and radiation damage resistance. Armored hull plus max hull hit points. Adaptive hull plating starship trait. I'm gonna have to slot that trait if I remember to do it. Unless it automatically slots into my new trait slot that came with this level 50 promotion. Cruiser Command Array. Command Strategic Maneuvering. Command Shield Frequency Modulation. Command Weapon System Synergy. Well, we're used to them. We had them on the previous ship. So, claim. And I might as well claim the others while I'm at it, because you never know, you might get traits with them at some point. So let's close that. Open the inventory, and here they are. All three ships. So let's, I'll just move these out of the way for now, so I can clear space in my inventory. Bit of lag on the recording. There we go, and I'm going to save lock boxes as I usually do. And repairs. And then get rid of all this stuff. Replicator. Bear with me, just a little bit of cleaning up needed to be done. That is the Martup for tactical captains. That is the Gorkon for science captains. And this is the Kalos War, the Kalos Battlecruiser for engineering captains, and I'm going to hit use. And it will be called the Tinkerbell 5. First rename is free. Done. Now I got to go and set the ship as my primary ship, which is with the ship selection officer down here. Now I will remove everything from my previous ships, because it's a waste of time keeping them loaded unless you're running out of inventory space. Because when you're not using them, they're only good for the Admiralty system, and it doesn't matter what loadout you've got, the loadout doesn't affect the ship's numbers in the Admiralty system. See if anything else. That's the ship we just got. But let's see if I can remove anything else from other ships. Ah, that's the one where the plasmonic leech came from. The Vandal Destroyer. I think it's a Norsican ship. If you want the plasmonic leech for every KDF character, just buy this ship on one character and claim it on all of them. Claim it for free on all the other characters, and you'll have a plasmonic leech for each character. And buying this ship once works out at about the same price as buying the plasmonic leech once. So Klingon officers only have to buy the leech once, whereas Federation officers have to buy it for each and every character, making it a lot more expensive to equip out your characters. Oh, I remember the Tinkerbell 2. I didn't rename that because I haven't used that ship, but I remember the Tinkerbell 2, the Vorture, the Tinkerbell 3, the Nagvar. And that's got nothing on it I need. The Tinkerbell 1, the tutorial ship, I think. The Tinkerbell 4, the ship I used just last. The silly little Tink 1 shuttlecraft. And the Tink 2 fighter. In fact, I'd better... ready shuttle, it says. Ready shuttle. To make that one my primary shuttle, I'll leave that stuff on it because I haven't got anything to put on it right now. And, let's ready this new ship as well. So there we go, no mastery at all. And it comes equipped with Mark 10 Brigadier General gear, which is a load of rubbish. And that's the console that comes with the ship, the Universal Adaptive Emergency Systems. And it won't really come into its own until I complete the mastery. Anyway, let's remove all this. Hang on one moment. Right, let's remove all this rubbish. AFK for two shakes. I think there was a knock at my door. It's all right, it was just the postman. So I don't have to pause the recording. So now we've removed the regular junk from the starship, the bog standard stuff it comes with, we can then go and decorate it at the ship tailor, and I might decorate my fighter while I'm at it as well. And what I've got available to spend on equipping it. Customize your ship. Well, first of all, we'll customize the shuttle because I realize I need to do better with that shuttle because I haven't paid any attention to it. Too hard to equip a shuttle, to decorate a shuttle. There's hardly any options. Veteran, I'm looking for the brightest colour, and I think that one. The logo should be my fleet, not the Empire one. And the decoration, Corvus of course, because that gives the most colour. Purchase and save for free. Now customize starship. There she is. Kalos War Cruiser. Ooh, she looks just like a Bortescue, except a bit more bulked up. A command flagship. The latest ships to be released by the game. Zenstor ships. Cool, this looks a lot better than I expected. And it looks like the nose is designed for ramming things. Big wedge, smack straight into a Romulan warbird. Ah, that would be good. Excuse me. So, left side view. Rotate down so I can see it better. It's not exactly centered on screen. So, that's its... Ooh, that changed it to the Bortescue look. Which is good. These controls in the ship tailor aren't that good. I'm trying to get the nose down. So the nose is near to us. There, that's better. That's a better look. In fact, it would make a pretty good screenshot with the shipyard in the background there. So change it from the original Bortescue style to the Kalis style, which is the ship's proper style, or the default design, or the Martag. Oh, I like that. The colour will show up on that. Or the Borkan. I like that even more. And that's the one I'm going to take. Set up the bridge. I like the Bortescue bridge because it's huge. Bortas, Kurum, Lily, Illy, Kristak, Sompek, Lakura. So that's the one I usually go with, but now that I've got the Bortescue bridge available, I think I might go with that. The Kalis bridge for the Kalis war cruiser? Nah. Or the Core bridge. I haven't purchased any of them, so I'm not going to bother with them. But I'm going for the Bortescue bridge because it's big and I like it big. But for the actual ship layout, I'm going for small. So the current default bridge and a small layout, so I'm not running all over the place when I want to visit my engine room and my crew lounge and such. The windows, type 1, 2 or 3, I like type 1. Material, that's too dark, that's okay, but it looks a bit old. That's nice and bright. That one, I don't think you'd see your own colours on it very well with all that darkness. And veteran's pretty okay, but I'm going for type 2. Then we choose my character's favourite colours. Pink. And do we want to change the saucer? I didn't know I had a saucer. You probably have to buy the ones with the little tick. This item is part of several different outfit packs. Please choose one. Oh, you get them for free. Tier 6 battle cruiser, of course. After purchase, go to shipyard to select this ship. Let's cancel
Okay.
that for a moment. Go through them again. I like the original Fortescue look. It looks bulkier. See, but the Fortescue or the Gorkon, which is the T4 outfit. Fortescue look meaner. But I still like the Gorkon nose. Okay. Now for the pattern. Corvus usually gives the most pink. So there it is. My mean looking tier 6 ship. And save and purchase this for free. So we have our ship decorated. There's the fighter with its lousy loadout. I can't see the Fortescue here anywhere. Maybe you have to change maps before you can see it. Which is fine by me because I've got to go to the exchange on Cronus and the first city to equip the ship. Look, beam me down to the first city, Mr. Transporter Chief, or I'm going to execute you for incompetence like I did the last one. Yep, I was the one that did it. Beam to first city. That's a bit of lag there, but to be expected when I'm recording my videos. Hopefully soon I'll get a new computer that can do better. So, now we go and buy the ship gear, which is always the fun part. Choosing gear for your ship. And I think Ursula's going to be with this ship for a long time, so I've got to choose carefully. However, I haven't got much EC at the moment, so I might have to update the ship later on in the week when I get me wages. Let's see if the ship shows up yet. No. Why not? Major General, I want Lieutenant General stuff now, so. Let's access the exchange. And bring up the ship. And the infantry. Well, it's pretty obvious the first few things to put on, which is temporal negotiator and subspace field modulator, which is something every captain should have. It comes from the episode Skirmish as a reward. So, weapons. Nope, let's choose consoles first, so it's very rare. Lieutenant General. Search. Oops. Would help if I went into consoles. Start with a tactical. And go for a disruptor. That's good. The Mark III, but they're expensive. Very expensive for my character. I mean, look at that. These are upgraded ones. And I can't really afford it. Really afford to equip my ship out with all of these, so what do I do? Maybe I should have sold some of my inventory stuff first. Things. Or I could just pop on these older ones. These not so good ones for now. I think I will buy one of them though. Leave it for a moment while I check out what the other consoles could be. Science. I suppose one of those. And one of those. Did I get the right one? Yes. For engineering, we put in the plasmonic leech. And we're probably going to need a turn rate for this big ship. And they are selling them, but there's no standard ones, there's only the extremely rare ones. I'm not paying 6 million, considering I've only got 7 million credits. So if we go to the next lowest rank, and then search, and that's more like it. May not be what I'd like, but it will do. And maybe we should do the same for these things, these consoles. These disruptor consoles. Yes, that's a bit more reasonable price. out more than what I've got. So we'd buy four of these. If we can afford it. One. Two. To fleet stuff on this ship, on this character yet, and it takes ages to request it in chat, which I have done before on another character. Science consoles. What rank is this one? Major General. I wonder if there's a Lieutenant General version of this. Let's give it a mark and see. Yes, there is, but they're too expensive for me. And the Major General version is no better than what I've already got. Oh, yes, it is. Oh, no, it isn't. I'm looking at the wrong one. So, the Major General version would have to do. Let's try this console. Get rid of the mark. And there we go, that's pretty good for this price. Let's go to Lieutenant General for that then. And that's where you get into the upgrade stuff. So, Major General. Let's just see if there's anything with three eyes. Let's see if there's something to do with EPS, because I don't really understand, but they say that EPS is DPS. Not too rich for my blood. Go to Major General. Power transfer rate. We will add that in. And we'll put on a standard neutronium hull. Unless, of course, there's anything better. Get rid of the mark. Oops. Million. What if we go to Lieutenant General? Look at the upgraded versions. 3 million, and that would clean me out, so no thank you. I'll stick with what I've got. Now for a deflector. More Major General stuff. Loved to have grabbed that if I had the cash. And there's nothing really better than what I've got. Oh, that has EPS on it. Right, I'm having that. It is better. That leaves me with next to nothing to buy my disruptors with. General, and even before I start, they're all too expensive. So we go to back to major. We should type in disruptor beam array. Now we've got some in my inventory. General rank, just like that. So if I'm stuck with Major General level, then I might as well just use what I've already got, which is put that on the ship and that. I'd like a torpedo on the front. Same, so put that in, and now we must buy another disruptor since I don't have one that's suitable. Have to go for the cheapest ones. I wonder if we can get an Omni for the back. Let's just type in the word Omni. Only Omnis are anti-proton, and the cheapest disruptor is over a million. What if we lower the rarity but increase the rank? Nope, that's not going to work. So I'm just going to put beams on the back. And nanite disruptors. If I get them, that will clean me out, but might be worth it. Now they don't seem to be better, but I do like to have those weird type things on my ship. But still, let's just go for the cheapest because we've got to fill it up. Can only afford to buy two more anyway. Oh, there's a nice cheap one all of a sudden right there. it. That's me spent out. We'll move that to there. So we can put this nanite thing on the front. Did I get another one? Yes, we got that. So what can we put on the back since we can't afford anything good? What if we lower the rarity? That's better. We can afford to put two rare ones on. Crit D and Crit H. And I saw accuracy in Crit H. So there you have it. That's the loadout. The best I can do with the money I've got at the moment. Now for stations. That is a Lieutenant Universal. That is a Lieutenant Commander Universal Command Station. I haven't used intelligence, command, or pilot yet for anything, and that comes later anyway when I can build up what I need in those areas. Now, I think I'm going to go for something with good engineering. So, that looks good for this slot. Better than that. Axiom beam, I don't really like axiom beam. And is auxiliary power to engines 1, that's good. Over here we want emergency power to shields 3. Ability, I might change that to engineering team. Although if I put shields and weapons free, I can't have fire at will free. So this is going to have to be a tactical station. You haven't got any other abilities, so let's go to see if he's got fire will free. Nope. You got fire will 2 though. So I'm going to have to purchase fire at will 3 from the exchange to put in there. See if I've got enough cash for it when I find it. Wow, all these Firewall ones being sold for over 40 grand, and they're available a lot cheaper from the train, from the officer training. Do they really expect people to buy them? And look, the cheapest one is beyond my pocket. unless I sell some of this, and then I might just about be able to afford it. And since I don't need any of it, I can sell it. Although I'd like to retain that neutronium armor and one of the torpedoes. I can sell... Ah, screw it, I'll sell everything. Sell it here, but I might get a few more valuable EC if I sell it to a vendor, so that's what I'm going to do. And I might need every single little EC I can get. I know there's a vendor in the exchange, but I'm not going to him because he'll rip me off, since he's a Ferengi. Talking to a vendor now, where we can sell what we've got. I'll open the inventory to make sure I don't sell things I don't want to sell. Yep, slightly more cash, not much, slightly more. And those items that I got from that came with the ship itself are worth nothing. Nothing in the replica, nothing with a vendor. Now let's see if I can afford fire at will, because you've got to have fire at will free if you're a beam boat. I don't think I'm going to achieve much DPS with the gear I've got, with the gear I'm getting for this ship, because it's limited budget. I mean, I only had 7 million EC and a few things from a previous ship. Let's see if we can afford that training manual now. Unless someone's put one on cheaper all of a sudden. All these Mark 1 training manuals. Who the hell's going to buy them when they can get them for about 2,000 or 200 or something from a skills trainer? Yep, we can afford it now. No, my luck, I've probably got it in my account bank. So now we find out what officer needs training up, and it's Talash. So we go to Talash, select him there, go to his skills, go to free, and put and get him to learn it. And make it his primary. Then go back to stations, click on that station, and put that there. Now I'm also going to need attack pattern beta. Hopefully I've got a tactical engineer that has that. Attack pattern beta 2. Sorry, not tactical engineer, you can't have a tactical engineer, I just meant a tactical officer. Let's put her there. And I know she hasn't got attack pattern beta 2, and I don't know if it's an exchange one or know if it's going to be on the exchange or if you can get it from the skills trainer. So let's look it up. There's an attack pattern beta 2. Can spell it. Training manuals, tactical search. Should be tactical ground, tactical space. You should have a filter for it, so you don't have to go for all these ground abilities. I think it might be available from the skills officer. Just want to see what price it is on the exchange first. So I can compare. Sometimes people will sell them slightly cheaper on the exchange. Be able to afford it. Still curious to know how much it's going to cost. Because attack pattern beta is like an emergency shielding, plus it also debuffs the enemy. Maybe you can only learn Tac Pan Beta 1 in this slot anyway. So let's have a look at players' skills, slot 2. Yeah, you can only learn Tac Pan 1. So it must be available from the skills trainer. Which means I've got to run all the way over to the skills trainer now for this officer. And then I'll probably find it cheaper on the exchange, typical. All about looking for beta 2 when you can only learn beta 1. On bridge officer skills trainer. There he is. Tactical space attack pattern beta. There it is. 2000. Now we train that officer in attack pattern beta. There it is. Got the manual. I mean, sure, that means she can give her that manual to read. And look at that, she learnt it really quick. Which means now we can make it primary. Go to stations, station and select it. Now, what does she want in one? Because we don't want two tag teams. What has he got in one? Ah, he's got photon torpedo. He can have that. So we're going to have a third tactical station now, and I have no idea what I want to put on it. But this is a universal station, so the Valera can go on here with those abilities, and we can put an engineer in here. With emergency power to shields. Yeah, we're going to need that. So I wonder which of these engineers will have emergency power to shields. Let's have a look at that one. Nope, he was already on here. Put him back. Let's look at that one. What do you have as your second ability? No emergency power to shields. Can you even learn it? Where is she? Yes, emergency power to shields 2 needs to be learnt. So, engineering space, emergency power to shields 2. Learn. Make primary. Go to stations, pick the skill, and put it in there. And do I really need emergency power to weapons 1, or is there something better? Well, he's got battery, so that might be better. What does battery do? Emergency power to auxiliary. Put that on there. And now for the science officer. I'd like one with science team, but I'd also prefer to have for all shields. -3.3 all shields each pulse. 10 pulse max. 135 targeting. I would rather a tractor beam in there. Energy signature. We'll have to go with her, we'll have to train her in tractor beam. So, Leska. Skills 2. And has she got tractor beam? It says she's already got it, so if we make it primary, then go to stations, click on that, she already had it, but it wasn't showing up until I went to make it primary. So those are my space abilities sorted out. Now something I usually forget when I'm making ships. See how much EC I've got left. Out of 7 million, I've only got 100,000. Something I normally forget when making ships is the active space roster. And Law was on my previous ship, so why is he not there now? Got no Epic, got no Ultra Air, and all I've got is Law for torpedoes. Chance to restore shields after brace for impact. Chance to reduce time for projectile weapons. We're switching with Law because Law's a better version of him. Swap. Now for rare officers. Haven't got any uncommon officers. I've got a few. Chance to restore shields after brace for impact. Chance to restore shields after brace for impact. Recharge time breach officer abilities reduced. Recharge time and science officer abilities reduced. So I'm going to replace one of these with drains target shields with tractor beam. That might be good. So I think we'll replace him. We've got a technician. Now, anyone else need replacing? Let's have a look at what we got in the uncommon. Get rid of all the others. Recharge time reduced on transwarp. Weapons officer, chance to reduce time to recharge torpedoes. Shield distribution recharge after. Chance to restore shields when taking damage while brace for impact. Chance to reduce time to recharge using subsystem attacks. Using subsystem attacks, does that mean when you're attacking the enemy weapons, or is it when you're using your fire at will? I'm not sure. But I'm going to leave it at that for now. And then it's respec myself. These buttons are lagging. Better. I'll clear all and start from scratch. Well, weapons training, of course, all the way up. And this ship's going to be a tank, so we're going to need shielding. Flow capacitors do, it does tachyon beam, energy siphon, charge particle burst. No thanks, I'm not using tachyon beam, although I do have it. Attack patterns, might as well fill that up since she's got beta. And driver coil improves Starship warp speed and full impulse, that's interesting. Starship batteries, we don't usually use them, although I've got one. Improved Starship hull healing. Engineering team, hazard emitters, auxiliary to structural miracle worker. Well, miracle worker is needed. Probably going to need warp coils, but we'll put some skills in there if we have any left over. So energy weapons, of course. Not really worried about my torpedo. More shields. Power insulators. Resist energy and shield drain. Course, improve subsystem repair, improve starship hit points, warp core potential, of course, that includes power levels. So now I've got a choice between starship integrity, subsystem repair rate, or projectile weapons. quickly, or do I want to go down slower? To repair quicker. EPS, we're gonna need that filled out. Improve starship power transfer rate. Definitely need that filled out. Warp core potential again. Particle generator, we don't need that. Improves knocks, repels and slows. Tractor beam. That's for the tractor beam, but we'll leave it for a moment in case there's anything better, like this improves your starship's defense value. The higher your defense, the harder you are to hit. Actually counter ship's defense. So do I want accuracy or defense? Tactical captains who learn 6 ranks of this will unlock training manual for Beta 3. This skill improves your starship's accuracy value. The higher the accuracy, the more often you hit the target. The target's defense value can counter your accuracy value. If accuracy exceeds a target's defense and you have 100% chance to hit the target, your accuracy value will add to your critical hit. Well, there we go, that's that then. Impulse thrusters, well, we've got to put a few in driver coil. These aren't final, this is just me trying to work it out. Threat control, stealth, don't want to get hit too much. Shields, inertial dampers, resists holds and knocks. Engine performance, hull plating. Engine power, we've already got some engine power, so let's max out hull plating. I usually ignore this fourth one because it doesn't make a hell of a lot of difference. To starship weapon power, or improve starship projectile, improve starship energy weapon criticals. That's what you want. Auxiliary performance. Skill grants you a flat bonus to your auxiliary power level. The more points you have in Starship Auxiliary System performance, the greater the bonus. Engineering captains will unlock the bridge officer training manual to in emergency power to auxiliary 3. I think we'll go for that's as far as we can go, I think. That's all our space ability money spent. So our engines are going to be pretty rubbishy. But the ship will be able to tank. I gotta put a few in ground just because it won't let you put any more in space. So, weapons proficiency. Personal shield generator. Combat armor. Improved shield generator, medical generator, force field, dome, cover shield. Laser turret, quantum mortar support drone. I've got loads of turrets. But willpower will resist knocks on repels. So it's one of them too. Spend a few more on ground. So, demolitions for mines, orbital strike, that'll do. It's not going to let me respec this because I still have more to spend somewhere. What's the problem now? It's not going to let me have these skills. Why? You have not spent the maximum number of points in one or more ranks. What if we sacrifice got to sacrifice something, a bit of tractor beam, I suppose, maybe. Put it into impulse thrusters. No, that's not going to work. Put it into driver coil or subsystem repair. Think subsystem repair. What if we get rid of all that? We sacrifice from just now. Still not working out. Roll on the new skills system. Sacrifice turrets and drones. Ah, I know what's wrong. Spend a bit more in space somewhere other than one of these. So if we sacrifice 1 point of accuracy and put it into engine performance, that's done it. We can accept that. So we have our new skills. Next thing is to retrade, because you always lose your trades, but you have to change map to get that to work. Or else you might lose your traits when you change the map. So let's beam up and have our first look at this ship. Our first look at the ship from space. The Tinkerbell 5. There she is. Always hidden in shadow when you come and see them. You can't have a good look because of all the people around. There she is. Lovely ship. Mean looking ship. So let's retreat. Since all the traits are suddenly gone. Starship traits. How come I only have one starship trait? Space reputation, nothing. Ground reputation, nothing. Because I haven't done my reputations yet. I haven't played any improved my character's reputation, because I don't normally do that until level 60. Well, actually, I do that at level 50, but I've still got one story arc to play through. Some episodes to play through before I do it. So we're just going to have to make do with Lucky. Rifle training. Anything good, so it's all about resists. Space. Accurate. Elusive. EPS batteries give a secondary boost to all subsystems. Might be useful. Great under fire, definitely. Beam training. Inoculus, not really appropriate for a cruiser, but what the hell, operative. Warp core potential, maybe not the best choices, but they'll do until I can figure out something better. Specialization is intelligence or pilot. I haven't spent any specialization points. I'm not sure it's unlocked. So now it's my toolbar. So we get rid of everything and start fresh. There was a button where you could just clear it. Right, there we go. First things first. Go into that, go into free. Hit attack and raise that all the way up as far as it'll go. And let us out. Oh no. Raise that all the way up as far as it'll go. Then lock it. And then raise that up as far as it'll go. Lock it. Raise that up as far as it will go. And lock it. Will this go further? Shall we unlock that? Raise it up as best it can go. Lock it. Save. Set the preset to current values. There we go, back to the numbers. See the numbers. 120, not 125. Go to 3. Now we go auto fire. This boat is built for broadsiding. Weapons, torpedoes. Emergency power weapons. Single torpedo. High yield. Emergency power shields. Now, why have I got emergency power shields too? Is that the best I could do? Oh well. Shields. Basic maneuvers. Fleet support. Where is it? Fleet support. Engineering fleet, engineering team, EPS power transfer, miracle worker, tractor beam. There or there, I usually put beta there. So there. Temporal negotiator. Tactical team. Subspace field modulator. Science team. Pirate distress. I That's what I got from the last story arc. From playing the last story arc. The pirates will come to my aid whenever I want them. What does this do? Plus 60 stealth. Auxiliary power improves knock repel and slow, improves exotic damage, improves hold and disable. That's much more interesting than I expected. Take pad and beta, of course. Although I suppose I can switch them over. There's that new ability that comes with the ship. When activated, the adaptive emergency systems provide a substantial boost to damage as well as kinetic and energy damage resistance. This ability's effects are improved slightly if used when hit points are below 50% of your maximum. Whoever lets it get that low. Brace for impact. Now am I missing anything on my main bar that I normally have? Look like it. So a few empty spaces, but that's fine. I'm thinking I'll switch that one with that one on this build because I'm going to be hitting that a lot. Improves all my resists. Plus 107.8 turn rate. Turn rate strength, that would be good for when I'm caught in tractor beams. So the next step is to put on the weapons. Start with the beams. Beam 1. Beam 3, beam 4, beam 5, beam 6, and beam 7. And then there's the torpedo. And now we must put them in the right order. So that one should be in that slot. And 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 there we go, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's it, that's good. Now we finally got quantum slipstream drive. Looks like someone else is building their abilities up as well. By the sounds of things. person next to me. Testing out their ship's abilities, getting them in the right places, see if they buff the right things. So where are those shield things? There we are. And Suliban trade freighter. Is it Suliban? I don't know. Doesn't look like it, I must have got rid of it. So, in this slot we'll put something odd in, the batteries. Oh, fireworks display can go in there. And up here, I can put in batteries, although I think I'll put them in there actually. Since I've got the space for them, probably move them later. A lousy fighter. A lousy fighter can go there. It's only a pet, it's not a combat pet. So if I'm going to put in batteries, I might as well put a shield one in down there. Speed, Lobby crystals, abandoned ship. I think that's everything. Yep. Now I think what I'm going to do is switch that with that. Move that across there. And move these out like that. Switch this back to 2. And now we can check the stats, but let's go away from all this noise of these other players so we can do that. So our maiden voyage, our maiden flight. And the turn rate sucks. Oh no, it's not so bad actually. Towards the sun. Set the controls for the heart of the sun, yeah. But the full impulse isn't much different from normal impulse. for the power levels to change. Okay, everything's back up. Now we can have a look at we can make loadouts. New slot. Standard for stuff that I know that works. And unstandard, which will be the same loadout, but sometimes I might want to change something as an experimental. That's why I call it unstandard. Save to them both, even though it's not necessary to do so, but I don't trust loadouts from holding onto things. Now finally we get to look at our stats. And if you remember on the previous ship, what was it, about 20% accuracy, 5%, 3% crit H, and 50% critical severity? That was the previous ship. Let's have a look at this one. Brr, it's pants. Critical severity is pants. But the accuracy is good. The chance isn't that good. The shields aren't that great. But the hull is good. And that power transfer rate is major. 406. How the hell did I do that? And the resists. Per second, that's brilliant. Turn rate isn't that good, but let's give it a shot at full impulse to see what its bonus defense will be. Well, maybe not full impulse, but flight speed impulse. Bonus defense is pretty good, and if we hit this, watch these resists. When I hit this, nothing happened. Didn't work the way I expected. Oh well. Nothing ever does for me. Maybe I haven't got the right consoles in, but still. I suspect this ship is going to do pretty well, even if its severity is pants. Oh, tactical team, look what it did. All this does is raise my kinetic resist. I might actually switch it out. It would sacrifice that though. I might switch that out because that does something. Just look at the cooldown, takes too long. So it's tactical team, the one that gives me the good. No, it wasn't. Or was it a combination of that and tactical team? Something just did it. Yeah, it's that's doing it. But it's only every 2 minutes. And how long does it last? What, 15 seconds? That's 50 down to 30 seconds. 30 seconds in every 2 minutes. So this thing is practically useless. Ah, it's for flight turn rate, isn't it? So let's have a look at the turn rate. 12.5 degrees, 16 and 27 flight speed. That's what it does. What does this do? Emergency power to auxiliary, and then auxiliary power to inertial dampers. That might be the way to do it. Let's give it a moment to cool down. And this. See what that does. 600 puts the power transfer rate up to 600. That adds to my resists. That adds to my flight speed. And then goes the defense. Isn't very good. So it's not a very tanky ship. Well, it is actually, but not at the moment. Not until I iron out some of this equipment. If I got the Mako set on this ship, it would be bloody good. To promote any of my officers while I'm here. No. Yeah, commander's the maximum rank they can be, I think. Fat for a Klingon. So there you have it, my new ship. Now, shall we test it in one of the dailies, maybe? Hmm. No, I tell you what, we won't test it for this video. Yes, we will. We'll test it in Trellis system. Trellis satellite repair, if I can find it. Oh no, we can't do that for 17 hours. What is that? With our recent efforts to reclaim territories lost to the treaties and Neutral Zone, the Federation has stepped up their efforts to menace the people of the Rokkalon Empire. Let's see what this is all about. Find and join the battle in the Yavet system located in Bimov Sector. No, that's not the one. Trying to find a nice daily. Enter Chos Nebula in the Omega Illionis sector block and scan anomalous readings you find there for traces of Cardassian fleet. That's the one. Yep, we're going to test it in a daily. Clearing out Cardassians. Intercept the Cardassian fleet in the Chos Nebula. So here we go. Let's head to the Chos Nebula and see how this ship does. Although I'm pretty nervous about it, it's not got much critical severity. But I never really went for that with my weapons. I went more for accuracy than severity. Right, let's find that nebula, the Chos Nebula. There it is. Ooh, it looks like a mean ship. Real mean. If it weren't called Tinkerbell. It's funny, the new command ships didn't have, the new flagships didn't have what the old command ships had. I mean, the Fortescue had a major cannon on the front. Or am I just mistaking it for the tactical one? This doesn't seem to have that. Maybe if I opened up those other ship boxes, it might give me more ship traits, but I'd need more ship slots to open up them. So let's try this ship in battle with the Cardassians in the Chos Nebula. Nebula. Joint defense against the Cardassians. The Cardassian fleet is hiding in here somewhere. Scan the anomalous readings in the nebula in order to ascertain their location. There may be some phantom signals due to the ambient radiation, but stay vigilant and keep up your search. Okay, so we've got to scan these anomalous readings for Cardassians. Whoops, wrong button. Scan signal. Whoops, went too fast. Yep, getting used to the controls. It is quite maneuverable, actually. The there were Cardassian ships here recently, we should continue our search further into the Chos Nebula. Okay, let's go for that one. Seems quite maneuverable out here in sector sort of space. Sort of sector space. Nope, that's another one missed. Now what about that one? Seems a bit too maneuverable or slippery. Might be different if we get in against the Cardassians. And here we go, we found some. Just give it a moment to load. Although it's loading very slow. Why is it at 0%? The percentage is the amount of load, not the amount of time until it's loaded. But the amount of data that has loaded. For some reason it's taking its long time, and now it's patching. That's what slowed it down, it was getting ready to patch. Here we are in the Chos Nebula, and there's some Cardassians there straight away, so let's get things going. Who will target them first then? One down. Two down. Oh, now the maneuverability's gone to pants. And I didn't even get a chance to enjoy that battle, it was on me straight away. Let's have a look at this over here, see what we can do to kill him off. So, heavy escort. And we just waltzed right over him. I remember from earlier today when I was playing the Federation version of this in my attacking the Federation version in my previous Klingon ship. That those escorts were a lot harder to take down, but then so were the science vessels, whereas the frigates were easy. The runabouts were a little bit of a pain. Oh, Jem'Hadar battleship. Yep, Cardassian allies. Glorious target! That was a nice broadside. That new console is just not worth it. It does a lot of good for your ship, but the cooldown is so long that it just isn't worth it. I mean, with other things that cool down quicker, you could achieve just as good. Just do it over time. Instead of all in one big burst. Quadrant Soldier. Well, it just waltzed all over those three, but those were the easy ones. Let's go for something like this. Maybe that's another Jimadar cruiser, or maybe it's one of those big Cardassian battle boats. Similar to the Kazon ones. No, it's just a Gala class. We should be able to just pummel that to death easily. I'm not going to put on full impulse because that will destroy my power levels, and my shielding is zero because I'm cloaked. So we go get into range. Side time. Easy. Although I notice my shields are going down a lot more quicker. Those shield consoles I've got into increase shield capacity and resist shield drain don't do much. I want him. I want that one. This is very dangerous going in amongst all these ships. Yep, the Jimitar battleship is no match. Yeah, got me full broadside going. Return to Commander Mars. Mara, Mars, or whatever. I thought we'd have to scan three anomalies and kill three different groups, but no, not in this case. So therefore we can contact her. Commander Mara and collect Dilithium and skill points. And there we go. Let's take the ship back to Cronus. The ship performed okay. I'm not 100% impressed, but I was expecting worse. Because mostly because of my build, my budget build. I mean, I practically scrimped this ship's build together. scrimped from my little bit left that I've been spending on all my other previous ships for this character. I should have called it the IKS leftovers. Leftover scraps. No, we don't want to do that. You just want to go back to Cronus. Where we can feel comfortable and safe in our new chunky ship. Chunky ship. I wonder if I put the old console from the previous Bortus on this ship, would it give me the big cannons? Stabilize Omega, no. Not with my mouse. It's just not worth it. So there you have it. Imagine that being like Knight Rider with the flashy zoomy light that goes boom zoom zoom zoom, or a Cylon. So there you have it. Ursula has got her new Kalos War Battlecruiser Tier 6 version of the Tier 5 Bortus Q. One of the new command flagships, and her power transfer rate is through the roof. Well, I hope you enjoyed meeting the Tinkerbell Freeze first build from scraps that were left over. This is Alt Lexington playing Ursula for Meraki Revenge. Please like and subscribe, and if you watch my next videos, it will be the Romulan mystery videos. I believe that's what the story arc is called. Well, thanks for watching, enjoy your gaming, have a good day. Bye.